I'll show you my setup and my process of shooting food photography. Today we're gonna shoot the brownie, and just wanna show you a quick setup that I'm using. I have the light coming from this side, the camera is overhead, and this is my actual setup. I'm shooting tethered, so whatever we are seeing on set, we're gonna see directly on the camera. So I'm gonna show you my process, how I do it along the way. So this is the actual setup, this is the first image, and we're gonna take it progressively. We're gonna start cutting the brownie into pieces and eventually add some powdered sugar on top, and we're gonna take a picture all along the way. So first we're gonna start by the first image to make sure that everything is as desired, the lighting and the focus. So we're gonna zoom in to check the focus and the light. So for now it's looking good. We're gonna take another shot and start cutting the brownie and take a shot along the way. So we're gonna get the knife from here and start by cutting the brownie. Let us put the live view on so we can see how it's looking. We can actually center it a bit to the image. We have a piece of paper under it. It's a baking paper. And I'm gonna put it a bit to the back. And I'm gonna start by cutting probably this much of it. And we're gonna go ahead and cut it right now. Here it is, the first piece it's cut, and we're gonna take a picture also for now. I will grab a napkin so I can clean my hands. I'm gonna hold it here. Okay, so this is looking nice. I'm gonna make sure it's not on the edge, so I have some space lower under it. So I'm gonna put the live view mode again and put it a bit higher. And then I'm gonna cut the same pieces from here. Starting to look interesting. It's always nice when you start adding a bit by bit. So in the beginning, as you saw, the whole piece of brownie was a bit dull. And now that we're adding some movement to it, it's gonna look nicer. And eventually with the powdered sugar, it's gonna look even nicer. So let's take a shot again. It's looking great. And I like also to work this way, to have a shot along the way. So maybe we can make a stop motion at the end, or even like we get to select which image we like the most. And this is a part of storytelling, so it's really interesting. Let's put again the live view mode. As you can see, the process is a bit long and you have to be patient along the way. Everyone does it his own way, but I really like to work this way. So I'm gonna show you again how I'm gonna cut the third piece. There you go. It's still attached, so I'm not moving them apart. And then I'm gonna take another shot. And so on and so on. If you like what you watched, please show thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next one.